Hello class 10, today I am going to discuss the RTCs or reference to context questions of the poem Enemies. Let's have a look. Now first is, I think I could turn and live with enemies. They are so placid and self-contained, I stand and look at them long and long. Children, you can access these questions from the portal as well. So if you have a problem of visibility over here, you can see it in the school portal. First question is, name the poem and poet. Very direct question, I will not explain it. What does the poet say about enemies? What he is saying, that they are placid and self-contained. Then, trace a word from the extract that means serene. You have to trace from the extract. What it could be, you have to find it on your own. Then the poet looks at them, very clear. You can do it on your own. Then the second is there. The poet wants to live with animals because of them. You will do it on your own again. The two qualities of the animals mentioned in the passage are, it is the repetition of the question discussed above. Find a word that means serene. Again, it is a repetition. Name the poem and the poet. Children, I have given you these questions in two ways. It can be either as this way or that way. You can do any which ways. But in notebook, when you will be writing, I know the answers are same. So what you can do, like name the poem and the poet is given. Already given over there. So you will write it once. Then what does the poet say about animals is given over here. You will write this. And you can write or. The two qualities of the animals mentioned in the poem are. Both the ways it can be written. Then trace a word from the extract that means serene. Or find a word that means serene. You will write both the questions in your notebook. Okay. Then second one is. They do not sweat and whine about their condition. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. First is, name the poem and poet. Direct question. Who does the pronoun they stand for? Who are they over here? Enemies. Then who weep for their sins? Who weeps for their sins? Sorry. The human beings. Then, who do not discuss their duty to God? Animals do not discuss their duty to God. Now children, what happens in the boats? Most of the children in hurry, what they do? They write human beings. Because discussing their duty to God is mentioned in the poem that it is done by humans. But in a hurry, they do not read it properly. Do not. Please read the question properly. Then, who are they referred to here? It is same. Then, what do they not do at their condition? They do not cry or whine or complain about their condition. How do they feel for their sins? Who are they? The humans over here. Their duty is towards themselves. Their long question. I have not discussed any long question in the previous poem. But in this you will write. Mention three things that humans do and animals do not. And now how will you make it a long question? Long answer, children, what you will be doing, you will be mentioning one quality at a time and describing it in detail. Okay, so complete this work in your literature notebook and stay updated with whatever is uploaded. Thank you.